Good morning. Today we will start with the exercise 4.2. Before that, we will solve some example problems. So first is solve 3n plus 7 equal to 25. What is it solve means? You have to find the value of n such that if you substitute that number for n, you have to get this 25. What I mean is, so 3n plus 7. You have to substitute some number for this n, such that when you do this calculation, you should get your answer as 25. Okay, that is what means by solve for n. So how to do that is, first you take 3n plus 7 equal to 25. What are the terms on the left hand side is, 3n is one term, 7 is one term, 25 is another term on the right hand side. So leaving the term with n, move the all other terms to the right hand side. 3n is here, keep 3n here. You have to move 7 from the left hand side to the right hand side. So moving, I am going to write as transposing. Okay, transposing plus 7 from left hand side to right hand side. I am going to move this plus 7 from here to here. So what will happen when you transpose it, this plus 7 will become minus 7. So 3n equal to 25 minus 7. Okay, what is 25 minus 7? 3n equal to 25 minus 7 is 18. Now we have to find what is n here, but we are having a 3 here, which is 3n is 3 multiplied by n. Okay, 3 multiplied by n equal to 18. This is the equation we are having. Now I don't want this 3 to exist here. I want only n to be in the left hand side. So to remove this 3 from here, what I should is divide by 3 on both sides. So what does it mean is, if you divide by a number on both the sides of the equation, the value of the equation will remain the same. Okay, you can divide or multiply any number on both the sides of the equation. You should not multiply it on only on one side. If you do the divide, divide it on both sides. If you multiply, multiply it on both sides. Now I am going to divide by 3 on both sides. So 3n divided by 3, that is equal to 18 divided by 3. I multiplied 3 on both sides. Here what will happen is, this 3 and this 3 will get cancelled. Okay, which is n equal to 6. So this is the solution for the equation. Let me check what I told you is 3n plus 7. So if now I am going to substitute n equal to 6 here, and I am going to find what is the answer, which is 3 multiplied by n, which is 6 plus 7. This is 18 plus 7, that is equal to 25, which is in the question. 3n plus 7 equal to 25. Therefore, n equal to 6 is the solution. This is the right answer. What we have did is correct. Okay. So the next problem is 2p minus 1 equal to 23. This is the next step. Here you can see you have to find a value for p. Now we are having a minus 1 here. What I am going to do is 2p minus equal to 23 transpose. Always you have to transpose number with the sign. Minus 1 you are going to transpose from left hand side to right hand side. So what will happen if you transpose minus 1 becomes plus 1 here. So which is 2p divided by 24. Now you know that how to remove this 2 here. You have to divide by 2 on both sides. So what is 2p divided by 2? That is equal to 24 divided by 2. Now here, this, what is this 2p is 2 multiplied by p. Okay, now we can cancel this 2 ones are 2. So remaining is 1. P multiplied by 1 is going to be simply P. Okay. So I am going to cancel this 2 and 2, which is P, that is equal to 12. P equal to 12. Let me check this. What is the question is 2p minus 1. So instead of this p, I am going to substitute 12. 2p minus 1, which is 24 minus 1, 23. I got it. Okay. So p equal to 12 is the right answer. Now we are going to start with the exercise 4.2. Solve x minus 1 equal to 0. Now we have to find what is the value of this x. So you are having a minus 1 here. The first step is transpose minus 1 from left hand side to right hand side. So what will happen? This minus 1 when goes from here to here becomes plus 1. So x equal to 0 plus 1. Okay, so that is equal to x equal to 1. Now we can check. So what is x minus 1? Instead of this x, you have to substitute the answer here, 1 minus 1, which is 0. Okay, we got this 0. Now the second question is x plus 1 equal to 0. Now what you are going to do? Transpose plus 1 from left hand side to right hand side. So this is x equal to 0. This plus 1, when it goes from here to here, it will become minus 1. So x equal to 0 minus 1 is minus 1. Let me check it here. What is x plus 1 is? For this x, substitute minus 1 plus 1, which is 0. So the solution we got is correct. The third problem is x minus 1 equal to 5. X minus 1 equal to 5. So transpose minus 1 from left hand side to right hand side. So minus 1 will become plus 1 here. So x equal to 5 plus 1, which means x equal to 6. Now we can check here, what is x minus 1? X we got as 6. So 6 minus 1 is 5. The 5 is here. Okay. The next is x plus 6, that is equal to 2. Transpose plus 6 from left hand side to right hand side. So this plus 6, when it moves to this side, becomes minus 6. 2 minus 6. So x equal to minus 4. Okay, let me check here, what is x plus 6? What is x is? X is minus 4. Minus 4 plus 6 is 2. So we have got this answer. Okay, next problem is y minus 4 equal to minus 7. Now transpose minus 4 from left hand side to right hand side. So this minus 4 will become plus 4, minus 7 plus 4. So y equal to minus 3. The greater number sign is 7. So it is negative, minus 3. So we can substitute y minus 4. What is y here is minus 3. So minus 3 minus 4, which gives minus 7. So you got it answer correctly. Y minus 4 equal to 4. Now transpose minus 4 from left hand side to right hand side. Now what will happen? Y equal to 4, this become plus 4. Y equal to 8. You can check, what is y minus 4? Y is 8. 8 minus 4 is 4. You got this 4. The next is y plus 4 equal to 4. So now transpose 4, which is plus 4, from left hand side to right hand side. So y equal to 4. This 4 when goes to from here to here becomes minus 4. 4 minus 4 is 0. What is y plus 4? Y is 0. 0 plus 4 is 4. You got this 4. And next is y plus 4 equals minus 4. Now transpose plus 4 from left hand side to right hand side. So y equal to minus 4. This is a minus 4 here. Okay. Now this plus 4, when it goes to that side, becomes minus 4. What is minus 4? Minus 4 is minus 8. Y equal to minus 8. Now I am going to check y plus 4. This is y plus 4. What is this y? We got as minus 8 plus 4. That is minus 4. We got this answer correctly. Next problem is solve 3L equal to 42. Here you can see here we have to find what is L here, but here it is 3 multiplied by L is there. I don't want this 3 to be here. So what I will do is 3L equal to 42 divide by 3 on both sides. Whenever you are dividing, you have to divide it on both the sides. So 3L divided by 3, that is equal to 42 divided by 3. I am dividing by 3, 3 on both sides. Now what is this 3L, which is simply 3 multiplied by L is 3L, equal to what is 42 by 3 is 14. And here what will happen, this 3 and this 3 will get cancelled. So here it is a 1. L multiplied by 1 is L. L equal to 14. Okay. Next problem is B divided by 2 equal to 6. Now I don't want this 2, but 2 is in the denominator. So multiply by 2 on both sides. Okay. So which is actually B by 2 equal to 6. I am multiplying 2 on both sides. Here is the 2, here is the 2. Both sides have multiplied. So now what will happen? This 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. Always we have to cancel number in the numerator and the denominator. So this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. You will get B here. And what 6 multiplied by 2 is 12. B equal to 12. Even now also we can check here. What is the question is B divided by 2. So the answer we got it, what is B is 12. 12 divided by 2, which is 6. We got the 6. Okay. The next is P divided by 7, that is equal to 4. P divided by 7, that is equal to 4. Okay. So multiply by 7 on both sides. So 7 multiplied by P by 7, that is equal to 4 multiplied by 7. This 7 I am multiplying on both the sides. So this side, left hand side, this 7 and this 7 will get cancelled. So P will be remaining. On the right hand side, 7 multiplied by 4 is 28. Here we can check what is P divided by 7. P is 28 divided by 7, which gives 4. You got this 4. The next problem is 4x equal to 25. So I am going to divide by 4 on both sides. So 4x divided by 4, that is equal to 25 divided by 4. Okay. Now this 4 will get cancelled. So x equal to 25 divided by 4. Okay. Now you can check it here. 4x. Okay. So what is 4x is 4 multiplied by x. 4 multiplied by what is x? 25 divided by 4. Now this 4 and this 4 will get cancelled, gives 25. Okay, this way you can check your answers. Next is 8y equal to 36. Now we have to divide by 8 on both sides. 8y by 8 equal to 36 divided by 8. Now what will happen? This 8 and this 8 will get cancelled, which gives 36 divided by 8. So here 36 by 8 equal to 9 by 2. You can cancel in 4. 4 2s are 8, here it is 9 4s are 36. So that is equal to 9 by 2. Now we can check what is 8y. So which is 8 multiplied by y is 9 by 2. Okay, now we can cancel this 9 by 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8, which is equal to 36. We got this. So the next is z by 3, that is equal to 5 divided by 4. So now you are having a 3 in the denominator. So multiply 3 on both sides. So z 3 multiplied by z divided by 3, that is equal to 5 divided by 4 multiplied by 3. Now we can see this 3 and this 3 will get cancelled. Z equal to, I am not able to cancel anything here. So just I am multiplying, 5 multiplied by 3 is 15 divided by 4. Okay. Now let me check it. What is z divided by 3? What is z here? Z is 15 divided by 4. So z, I can write like this, z divided by 3, 15 by 4 divided by 3, that is equal to 15 by 4 multiplied by 1 by 3, that is equal to 3 1s are 3, 3 5s are 15, which is 5 divided by 4. Okay, if you know fractions and decimals, you could be able to do this. So z by 3, instead of z, substitute 15 by 4. You can get cancelled, numbers get cancelled, and you will get 5 by 4. So your answer is correct. The next problem is a divided by 5, that is equal to 7 by 15. We have a number 5 in the denominator. So multiply 5 on both sides. 5 multiplied by a by 5, that is equal to 7 by 15 multiplied by 5. Now this 5 and this 5 will get cancelled, a. So what will happen here is 5 once of 5, 5 3 15, 5 multiplied by 3 is 15. So it is 7 divided by 3. Now if you want to check it, how will you check it? What is a divided by 5? Instead of a, you are having 7 by 3 divided by 5. So a divided by 5, that is equal to, this is a divided by 5. What is a? A is 7 by 3. 7 by 3 divided by 5, that is equal to 7 by 3 multiplied by 1 by 5, that is equal to 7 by 15. We got this correctly. Okay. Next is 20t, that is equal to minus 10. Now there is a 20 here, so divide by 20 on both sides. 20t divided by 20, that is equal to minus 10 divided by 20. Now what will happen? This 20 and this 20 will get cancelled. T equal to minus 1 divided by 2. Let me check it here. What is 20t? 20 multiplied by t. What is t? T is minus 1 divided by 2. Okay. So you can cancel. 2 ones are 2. 2 tens are 20. What is 10 multiplied by minus 1 is minus 10. We got it here. Okay. Now the next problem is, we are again going to solve. We have to solve for n. 3n minus 2, that is equal to 46. Okay. Now first thing is, you have to move all the terms, leaving this 3n term, whatever the term is remaining, you have to move to the right hand side. So transpose minus 2 from left hand side to right hand side. Okay, so which becomes 3n equal to 46 plus 2. Minus 2 will become plus 2 when it goes to the right hand side. So 3n equal to 46 plus 2 48. Now again a 3 is here, I want to remove this. So divide by 3 on both sides. So 3n divided by 3, that is equal to 48 divided by 3. Now what will happen here? This 3 and this 3 will get cancelled. So n equal to 16. So n equal to 16 is the answer. Now what I will do is, let me check it here. 3n minus 2. Okay. So if I substitute n equal to 16 here, I should get this 46. What is 3 multiplied by 16? Instead of this n, I am substituting 16 minus 2. Okay, so here it is 48 minus 2, which is 46. So I got this. So n is 16. The next problem is 5m plus 7 equal to 17. Now I have to move this 7 from left hand side to the right hand side. So transpose plus 7 from left hand side to the right hand side. So this plus 7 will become minus 7. So 5m equal to 17 minus 7. 5m equal to becomes 10 now. Now I want to remove this 5 from here. So I will divide by 5 on both sides. So which is 5m divided by 5, that is equal to 10 divided by 5. I divide by 5 on both sides. Now this 5 and this 5 will get cancelled, which gives m equal to 2. Now let me check it here. What is 5m plus 7? If I am substituting m for 2, I have to get this 17. So 5 multiplied by 2, which is 5m plus 7. 5 multiplied by 2 is 10 plus 7, that is 17. I got this 17. So 5m equal to 2 is correct. The next problem is 20p divided by 3, that is equal to 40. Okay. Now you can see here there is a 20 in the numerator and 3 in the denominator. You can move it one by one or together also you can move. Let me tell how it is. First, what I am doing is multiply 3 on both sides. Okay, I am multiplying 3 on both sides, which is 3 multiplied by 20p divided by 3, that is equal to 40 multiplied by 3. This 3 I am multiplying on both sides. Okay, now this 3 and this 3 will get cancelled. So 20p, that is equal to 120. This is one step. What is the second step? Now I have to remove this 20 here. Now divide by 20 on both sides. Divide by 20 on both sides. So 20p equal to 120. Divide by 20. I'm dividing by 20 on both sides. Now this 20 and this 20 will get cancelled, which is p here. And here what is 120 by 20? The 0 will get cancelled. This is 6, which is 6. P equal to 6 is the answer. That is one way of doing. Now another way is, what's the question is, 20p by 3, that is equal to 40. Okay. Another way is, you can multiply 3 divided by 20. Just this 20 by 3, take the reciprocal of that. Okay. This thing. 20 divided by 3, what is the reciprocal? 30 by 20. Multiply 30 by 20 on both sides. We did it in two steps. Now I am trying to do it in one step. So what happened is, 20p by 3 equal to 40. Okay, this is the question. Now I am going to multiply 3 by 20 on both sides. I have multiplied 3 by 20, 3 by 20. Now what will happen? This 3 and this 3 will get cancelled. And this 20 and this 20 will get cancelled. Whatever we did it in two steps, we are doing it in a single step now. So now we are getting a p. So what is this? 40 multiplied by 3 divided by 20. So here this is 2 20 2s are 40 and then 3 2s are 6. You can see we are getting the same answer, P is 6. Okay, previously we are first moving, multiplying by 3, removing the 3 here. Again you are dividing by 20. We are doing it in 2 steps. Here we can do it in a single step. Take the reciprocal and multiply it on both sides. Okay, now we can check. What is 20p divided by 3? What is p here is 6. So 20 multiplied by 6 divided by 3. Instead of this p, I have substituted 6 here. So 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6. 20 multiplied by 2 is 40. We got this 40. Okay. The next is 3p by 10 equal to 6. Now I am going to do it in a single step. What I will do? Multiply. What is the reciprocal of 3 divided by 10 is 10 divided by 3. Multiply 10 divided by 3 on both sides. So 3p divided by 10 equal to 6 is a question. I am going to multiply what 10 divided by 3 on both sides. Now what will happen here? This 3 and this 3 will get cancelled. This 10 and 10 will get cancelled. So p equal to 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6. 2 multiplied by 10 is 20. P is 20. Let me check this. What is 3p divided by 10 here? 10, that is equal to 3 multiplied by, what is p here is 20 divided by 10, that is equal to, which is 2 here, 3 2s are 6. You got this answer here. Okay. Now solve. This time I am not going to write everything in statement, just I am going to do it. 10p equal to 100. Okay, 10p equal to 100. So I am going to divide by 10 on both sides. So 10p by 10 equal to 100 divided by 10. Now this 10 will get cancelled. P equal to 10. Now if you want, you can check. What is 10p? 10 multiplied by 10, that is equal to 100. You got this. The second thing, 10p plus 10p plus 10 equal to 100. Now we have to move this 10 from the left hand side to the right hand side so that it becomes 10p equal to 100 minus 10. Okay. If you write equation in such a way that all these equal sign aligns, then it is easy for you to check. 10p plus 10 equal to 100. So 10p equal to this 100, this plus 10 becomes minus 10 here. So what is 10p equal to 90? Now here I am going to divide by 10 on both sides. So 10p equal to 90 divide by 10 on both sides. Now which gives here p equal to 9. Now if you want, you can substitute here. What is 10p plus 10? 10 multiplied by p. What is p is 9 plus 10. 10 multiplied by 9 is 90 plus 10, that is equal to 100. You got this answer. The next is p divided by 4, that is equal to 5. So I am going to multiply by 4 on both sides. 4 multiplied by p by 4, 5 multiplied by 4. I have multiplied 4 on both sides. Now what will happen? This 4 get cancelled. P equal to 5 multiplied by 4 is 20. Now let me check it here. What is p divided by 4 is 20. Instead of p, I am substituting 20 divided by 4, that is 5. We got this 5. The next problem is minus p divided by 3, that is equal to 5. Now here I am going to multiply 3 on both sides. Minus p divided by 3 equal to 5, multiply 3. Now what will happen in this side? 5 multiplied by 3 is 15. Here this 3 and this 3 will get cancelled, which gives minus 5. Sorry, which gives minus p. So minus p is 15. Then what is p is minus 15. Okay. So P is, if minus P is 15, then P becomes minus 15. What is the next is 3P divided by 4, that is equal to 6. Here again 3 by 4 is here, multiply by, if you want to write, multiply, I am going to write 4 by 3, multiply 4 by 3 on both sides. How I got this 4 by 3 is, take the reciprocal of 3 by 4, which is 4 by 3. So 4 by 3 multiplied by 3 by 4, that is equal to 6, multiplied by 4 by 3. Now what happened here? This 4 get cancelled, this 3 get cancelled. So P equal to here, 3 2s are 6 and 4 2s are 8. Okay, let me check it here. What is 3P divided by 4? That is equal to 3 multiplied by, what is this P is 8 divided by 4. I will cancel this, this becomes 2, 3 multiplied by 2 is 6. I got the 6. The next problem is 3 is equal to minus 9. I am going to divide by 3 on both sides. 3 is by 3 equal to minus 9 divided by 3. So which is s equal to minus 3. Let me check. What is 3s? That is equal to 3 multiplied by s. What is s? Is minus 3. So this is minus 9. I got it. So the next problem is 3s plus 12 equal to 0. Now first I will move this 12 from left hand side to the right hand side, which means 3s equal to 0 minus 12. So 3s equal to minus 12. Okay. Because 12 is the greater number compared to 0. So, you should put this minus here. Now, this 3 is here. I am going to divide by 3 on both sides. 3s by 3, that is equal to minus 12 divided by 3. So, s equal to minus 4. Okay. Let me try it here. Check it here. What is 3s plus 12? 3 multiplied by s. What is s? S is minus 4. Plus 12. 3 multiplied by minus 4 is 4 3s are 12, this is minus plus 12. Minus 12 plus 12 is 0. I got it correctly. So the next problem is 3s equal to 0. Okay, now you can see here from directly you can say s is 0. Still you have a doubt, the same thing we can do, divide by 3 on both sides. So this is 3s. Equal to 0 divided by 3. Okay, just I am dividing by 3 on both sides. This 3 and this 3 will get cancelled, which is s equal to 0. 0 by 3 is 0. So, if you want to check, which is very direct, 3 multiplied by s, 3 multiplied by 0, that is 0. Now you got that. Okay, what is the next problem is? 2q, that is equal to 6. Now what we can do, divide by this 2 on both sides. 2q equal to 6, divide by 2. This 2 and this 2 will get cancelled, so that q equal to 3. You can check, what is 2q? 2 multiplied by q, q is 3, that is equal to 6. You got the 6 here. The next problem is 2q minus 6 equal to 0. Now I am going to take this minus 6 to the right hand side so that it becomes plus 6. So 2q equal to 0 plus 6. 2q equal to 6. Now I have to remove the 2. So I am going to divide by 2 on both sides. 2q equal to 6. I am going to divide by 2. So now this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. Q equal to 3. Let me check, what is 2q minus 6? 2 multiplied by, what is this q is 3 minus 6. 3 multiplied by 2 is 6 minus 6, that is 0. Okay, I got this. The next is 2q plus 6 equal to 0. The same problem, instead of minus 6, we are having a plus 6 here. Now, this is this plus 6 when moved to that side becomes minus 6. So here you have to be cautious, you have to put minus 6 here. You should not put plus 6 because 6 is a greater number compared with 0. So now again I am going to divide by 2 on both sides. Now what will happen? This 2 will get cancelled, giving 2q equal to minus 3. Let me check my answer. What is 2q plus 6? 2 multiplied by minus 3. Instead of this q, I am substituting minus 3 plus 6, which is minus 6 plus 6, 0. I got this. Okay. Now, the last problem in this exercise is 2q plus 6, that is equal to 12. So, 2q equal to 12 minus 6. This 6 when moved to this side becomes minus 6. So, 2q equal to 12 minus 6 is 6. Now, divide by 2 on both sides, which is 2q equal to 6 divide by 2, q equal to 3. This 2 and this 2 will get cancelled and 2 3s are 6 will give 3. Let me check what is 2q plus 6 if q is 3. So, this is 2 multiplied by 3 plus 6. This is 6 plus 6, that is equal to 12. So, the answer you got q as 3 is correct. So, by this we are completing exercise 4.2. From next class we will start exercise 4.3. Thank you.